The Detroit Lions enter the third and the fourth round, fifth round. You're like, okay, you know, we don't have a third round pick. We don't have a fourth round pick, but we'll just kind of stand pat and get some things done in the fifth and sixth round or whatever. Next thing you know, Brad Holmes trades up twice to get into the fourth round, and we're going to talk about it. So we talked about in a previous video, he trades up to the fourth round and gets a kind of a project offensive tackle. Okay, fine. You know, I didn't like that. You give up a third round next year to do that. Okay. And then now he just goes up again to get a safety. Now, I really like this because I saw this safety Vackey out of Utah being mocked in the second round, third round consistently. So to get him in the fourth round is really good. He allowed one TD in coverage in 2023, and that was a 400 coverage snaps. He's a good safety, right? This is a good safety. We'll get more into him, but why the Lions have lost their mind is because they sent next year's third round to get Giovanni Manu, 6'8", 352-pound behemoth, who ran a 4.96 at his pro day and had a 33-inch vertical. Okay. I trust Brad Holmes, right? We're just at that point now. But you go down here a little bit further, and you can see that the Lions traded with the Eagles to move up to 132 in the fourth round to select Utah safety and former running back. I saw that he's a running back, too. The Lions traded to get up there. They traded 164, 201, and a fourth rounder next year. So we don't have a third or fourth round pick next year. And the Eagles are like, okay, fine. We'll see ya. And we get another like sixth round pick and two, and so we get a, and we get back 2010. So we get 132 and 210. Okay. So it's just like, dude, here's what we got. If we can land a combination of any of these guys, so there's a guy we just got. And Giovanni Manu. So this guy was all over it this morning. I'm not sure what to think because I love getting two. So we got a first round, second round. We didn't have a third round pick, but then we got two fourth rounders. I love that. But it came at a really steep cost, giving up a lot of draft picks. And next year's really been mortgaged now officially. I didn't want to say it has been mortgaged before, but now I think it's okay. So Brad Holmes, I thought his theory was, man, we can just find really good guys anywhere. We're really good at evaluating our draft picks. We'll find them when we need them. We just need draft picks. I didn't think he was super aggressive in coming up for players. He did it for Jameson Williams. He did it for Terrion Arnold, of course, this year. But these mid-round aggressiveness seems over the top to me. It doesn't feel necessary. I understand doing it once, but he did it twice. And really, he did three. So he's done three trade-ups in this draft. And in order to trade up, you got to give up stuff. And I agreed with the Terrion Arnold. And if you want to do one more, that's fine. But now to do three trade-ups seems just ultra, ultra aggressive. And it tells me a couple things. Number one, Brad Holmes believes in this team. Dan Campbell believes in this team that they're really good. And it's time to do what they did last year. NFC championship type games and Super Bowl. Like that's just the bar right now is NFC championship, which is just amazing. That's number one. Number two, Brad Holmes is showing I like certain guys and I'm going to go get them. Exactly what I thought he wasn't about. And it also shows where we're at in this rebuild. We're not in a rebuild anymore, but it shows that Brad Holmes was very smart and calculated early on. Now he's being very intentional and intense now. Like there's an intensity, like, dude, all right, I trust you. I don't know. So the Lions just continue to they're losing their minds is what it looks like. That doesn't mean it's a negative. It just means, whoa, okay, I don't like giving up the future picks because next year is going to be here like that. And it's like, wow, that'd be nice to have a third and a fourth round pick. But, and we'll get more into this Utah safety and here in a second, but it tells me that we don't have many holes. Let's be aggressive. Let's not just get a sixth round backup safety. Let's go get a guy that can be exactly who we want, and let's go get him right now. So, okay. Let's take a look at this Vackie. Again, I saw him a lot. I don't know if I'm even saying his name right, but here's his here's Giovanni Manu, first of all, his RAS score. Crazy good. Offensive tackle, because you take away his shuttle and three cone, which was poor. His height is just elite. Weight elite, bench elite, vertical elite, broad jump, good, great. 40-yard dash. Oh, my gosh. Love that. Okay. Man. He's a running back, but then he went to safety. Let me know your thoughts on this guy. All I know about him was that he was projected to be a second and third round guy. And we didn't have we didn't take him in the second round. We didn't have a third or fourth round pick. But Brad Holmes is like, man, and this kind of models his free agency and his cap model, which was like kick the can. Just keep kicking the can down the road. So next year, he could get back up into the third or fourth round, give a 2026 fourth round. You know, you could do this for a long time if you wanted to, I guess. So part of me is just in shock. Not like overly, right? Not being like too dramatic about it, but also curious we didn't address defensive end or interior offensive line with those aggressive picks. I guess that's where it's like, oh, be aggressive. Yep, boom, love it. It's like, oh, okay, a tackle. Okay. I mean, we do need a tackle. You do need depth there. And that's like safety. Yeah, I guess we do need a safety. We do need backup safety. But interior offensive line, I would have thought we would get something. And I thought, okay, fine, we'll get that in the fifth, sixth round. We just gave those picks away to the Eagles and got one back. So interesting. It's just very interesting. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Appreciate everybody that's been watching the videos, supporting. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't, and if you've been watching these videos throughout the draft process, because, man, it's just, we're in good hands with Brad Holmes. I trust him. Let me know your thoughts, and we'll see all of you on the next one.